Beijing's authorities have cancelled New Year celebrations this weekend as a precaution as fears about the spread of a deadly new virus grow.
More details of cases in the UK have emerged today. There are 45 people being treated in isolation at home.
A woman in her 70s has become the first person with coronavirus to die in the UK.
The NHS and other global health systems are struggling to contain the virus.
The coronavirus is the biggest threat this country has faced for decades, and this country is not alone. You must stay at home.
All schools across Britain will close by the end of the week until further notice as the death toll.
The British Prime Minister Boris Johnson has been admitted to intensive care with those persistent symptoms of coronavirus.
As the number of people infected by this disease continues to mount, so too the impact on all of our lives continues to become more and more profound.
It is now almost 2 months since the people of this country began to put up with restrictions on their freedom.
President Trump has backtracked on a suggestion yesterday that disinfectant could be used to tackle the virus.
Dominic Cummings does appear to have broken the lockdown.
For 2 months now, the UK schools have been quiet, closed but to the few children of essential workers.
They came to demand change, despite a deadly virus, despite the dangers of large crowds, organised under the rallying cry of Black Lives Matter.
Thousands of people attended two raves in Manchester last night. Apparently, the parties were billed as quarantine raves.
I can confirm today that retail outlets will be able to open their doors again from Monday, the 15th of June.